What's going on, Fit Babes? It's your girl, Coach Chris. Thanks for stopping by the Body by Chris YouTube channel, where we are all about empowering fitness newbies to step into the gym with more confidence, show everybody else who you are. So today I'm really, really excited because we are going to be talking about building a garage gym. I should have put this together like at the beginning of Corona, but you know, it seems like we're gonna be in this funk for a little bit of time where we don't have the gyms. So I'm gonna show you the pricing. I'm gonna show you all the details of what I got and what you should get if you want a little bit of an at-home space for yourself. You don't have to go all crazy and get all the bells and whistles, but it would be important for you to get a couple things as you start your fitness journey. So without further ado, let's jump into today's video. So as I mentioned, this is a garage gym. There has to be some flexibility and functionality in the space because I have to use it as a garage for my house too. I didn't want to just have a garage where I have like tools hanging on the wall or, you know, shelving where you can see everything and metal shelves and stuff like that. I wanted it to look really, really clean and organized and not distracting at all. So a couple things were really important to me: getting a storage so that I can be able to put things aside in there that have nothing to do with my clients or anything, and they stay out of sight, out of mind, nobody knows, and they look really, really professional, and they're white and clean. I got this whole set at Home Depot, and each little piece was individually purchased, so then you put them all together in the end to make this piece. And I've got a fan for when it's pretty hot outside. I have a little place for my ladder, which is just in out of the way. And I've got a fridge. This mini fridge holds all the waters for my clients and just for myself when I'm needing one after a workout, you know? I love this also because I'm able to keep this door open and have my dog stay with me out here. And I put this this little gate up so that she doesn't like run into the street. But I love it because it just allows me to have her outside and play around because I do have a detached garage, so it's not connected to the house. Makes it really, really nice from the backyard into the garage. She's able to kind of like move around and play. I will show you some things that you can buy that are not gonna break the bank though. You can get all of this done for less than $1,000 and have a little space within your home to have a full workout routine. So if you don't have clients, if you don't need all of the like heavy duty squat rack and things like that, and you're a complete beginner, you can get away with very minimal exercise equipment. And that's what I'm gonna show you today. But let's take a tour throughout the garage. Okay, so first up is this squat rack. Now this squat rack I purchased from a company called PRX Performance. It was not from Amazon. Love it because it has a very low profile. It doesn't stick out from the wall very much. And all I have to do is take the pull-up bar off and it converts into the wall. Like I can just push it back and fold it up. So it's not going to get in my way if at one point in the future I decide to park two cars in here. But for the time being, I haven't needed to park my cars, but I do want to have this empty space right out here to be able to do that if I want. And plus, when I see two clients at a time, it just gives us a lot more space to move around. You can use the bar, obviously. When this is not in use, I can put it right here. So I've got a little storage thing on the wall that's also from PRX. I haven't been able to find any really cool ones like this one, and I think it just makes it really clean. So I can put the bar up there, and I have another bar called the Easy Bar. And it just gets things out of the way when this is folded up. And you'll see that I have a little broomstick in the back too. And that is for a couple exercises because I do not have a cable machine in here. And we use that with bands to do some lat pull downs and different things like that. On this side, I've got my dumbbell rack. Just, it has everything. It's a 3-in-1. And I really loved it because it was functional like that. So you've got this little shelf up top, which is really cool. You can put all your little accessories on it. And then I've got my dumbbells in the bottom. I go all the way up to 25 pounds. And then on the sides, I've got little plates. These go on the barbells, but you know, they're kind of like tucked away on the sides. So this is perfect. Also, I got a landmine attachment. So this was really, really cool. If you're a beginner, you probably won't be using this very much, but basically I can put my barbell right in here. And I can do different exercises with it. So it's very flexible. It moves around everywhere.
and it's just really fancy and I like it, you know, and it just kind of hangs out there. It just chills. I didn't have to attach anything. I just picked this up and slid this under. So it works. Also, I've got a battle rope situation right here. This is really, really good for cardio, getting your heart rate up, high intensity. It extends all the way to the back, but I just kind of roll it up like that whenever it's not in use. Also, you'll notice these bins. All three of these were purchased at Target. I love the color. I think it just pops and it looks so good. And it just keeps a lot of the extra stuff, like the accessories. So you'll see that in here, I've got a foam roller. I've got two different ones. I've got a thin yoga mat. I've got a bunch of bands and I've got a couple different attachments for my bar. You'll notice this guy goes straight into the barbell and it's really, really good for doing back exercises, wide grip. I also have a close grip that you can use too. And this really helps with you just put the bar right here and you can do some really cool stuff with it. But again, these, if you're a beginner, not necessary. Plus you would have to have a barbell in order to do this. And so if you have a small space at home, probably isn't necessary and you probably won't be buying that. Okay, let's jump into this box. So in this box, I just have mats just to keep it really easy. This was my old one that I had, and I like it that it's super thin and I love the color. These two I bought for clients. They are thicker, so they're complete like exercise mats. I have noticed though that sometimes doing things like planks on them, it will move around and slide and bunch up. So it's not ideal. Sometimes the girls just wanna be on the floor and that's totally fine too. But these are really cushiony, so I like that about it. But these are all from Amazon again. This one, I don't think so. This was like Marshall's or something. I would recommend try to look for something that's gonna have a better grip. If you do want thick like this because you have hardwood floors, this is great for that. But if you have carpet, it may bunch up a little bit. This is also from Amazon, and I was terrified when I first got it. I swear, I was like, I hope it doesn't break. It was so heavy to lift. You definitely need like three people. So you keep that in mind. But mirrors are always really expensive, but I thought it was extremely important to have a big mirror in here because when you're in the gym, it is important, especially as a newbie, to be able to see yourself. Please, please, please do not create a space in your house to work out in without having a mirror to look at. That's really important. You guys need that for form, technique, you know, making sure you're doing everything the right way.
Now, one thing that I definitely recommend my clients get if you are trying to build a little at-home gym is a TRX. Now, this TRX, it's basically a suspension system. What it does is it allows you to work pretty much every body part that you need to work, but it allows you to hang on to it. So it can either provide more stability for you in the terms of like lunges and squats. If you have bad knees, you can take the pressure off by holding on to something, right? Or it can actually cause more difficulty. So if you're doing planks and you want to put them in here, you can do hamstring curls. You can do a lot of things where it's actually going to cause you to like strengthen up your core because you have less stability. So your body is just trying to figure out how to move and it's going to tighten up your core more and it's going to work your core a lot more. So these are very, very helpful and I do recommend, but you do need to know how to use these. So maybe I'll do a video in the future about how to do some exercises with this as a beginner. I don't know, comment down below if that's something that interests you, if you're kind of curious on how to use a TRX. But I do recommend this, and because it's so flexible, you can do it in any room of your house. I've got it attached to an anchor, if you can see it up here. The only issue I've got with it is because it's on the wall, it's actually more difficult for me to do certain exercises with it. So you just kind of have to play around with it. Usually I would recommend it up above, like in a doorway or on a pull-up bar or something like that. I just couldn't put it against the ceiling. I felt like there wasn't a lot of, like it was hard to find studs. It was just a whole process and I was worried and didn't want my ceiling coming down on me. You know, the things you think about, right? So I put it on the wall. I felt like it was a little more stable there and it wasn't gonna break my wall. So there you go. I definitely recommend buying one of those things. And if you have any questions, let me know in the comments below what you think and if you want me to do a quick video on how to use it. Another thing that is super easy for you to add in your home gym, it's a little bulky, but you can throw this under your bed no problem, or in a closet, is a Bosu. These also are really, really good at building your core strength because of the instability. Again, the key with the TRX and the BOSU is to give you a sense of wobble so that you're able to overcompensate and use your core to tighten up. You want something that you can do a lot with. And honestly, when you're a beginner, I actually recommend you not getting heavy dumbbells and crazy things like that. Figuring out how to use your own body weight to create resistance and intensity is actually the best thing you can do for yourself as a newbie. Don't go crazy and buy a squat rack when you're struggling with how to do squats. You know, get your squats right. So another couple things that I've got. You'll notice that I have an easy bar here and I have one on the wall. I really love easy bars, not only for hand, like bicep curls and things like that, that are the obvious choices. But if you are a beginner, I have plenty of girls that struggle to do squats with a 45-pound barbell. It's big, it's heavy, you're struggling to just build muscle. So we actually use the easy bar quite a lot, and I teach people how to do front squats with that thing. I get them to do back squats with it, even deadlifts at the beginning. Once we move over from dumbbells, we get more comfortable with a bar by using this before we go into the heavy 45-pound bar. So this is better because it is small, it's compact, you can keep it in your house somewhere under the bed or something, and it's actually functional for you. Like, you can do things with this that you won't be able to do with a barbell, right? Barbells are pretty heavy. So if you're a beginner, I would recommend getting this. It wasn't that expensive either. I'll link it in the show notes, but it's really doable. The last box that we've got here, it's kind of like going for treasure. So I've got a bar pad. This is usually what you're gonna put on your bar so that it's not hurting your hips when you do hip thrust. Super, super cool. Definitely recommend it. I've had this one for years. And then I've got some ankle weights. These have come in so handy with my girls. I would recommend buying these. They have a detachable little sand bags. So like, this is what it would look like. There's like five of them. So you're able to take how many you want out and just keep the rest. Super, super helpful. Like, you should get this at home. It's small. It's not gonna like take up too much space. It's cheap. It's a must for sure, especially for building the booty.